questions? You want me to talk or what?
Well, what? Okay, you come in to take over what was a really good and experienced and productive receiving corps, and you're not going to coach it, most of those guys.
That's right. Well, you know what? There's a good foundation in there, I think. You know, there's some young guys that are hungry. We don't have enough of them. That's why we're on the road grinding right now recruiting. So we got to get some more. There's no doubt. It's pretty depleted. But I met with all the kids. They're hungry. They're hungry for a change. You know, for me, it's good. You know, I got to have a silver lining losing a bunch of first rounders that, you know, there's no bad habits I got to break. I get to come in with a blank canvas. So.
Did you come in with a pretty good idea that this is what was going to happen? Both of those guys were rated as early round draft picks. Did you go in kind of thinking this might happen?
Yeah. I recruited Justin when I was in Florida. I knew what kind of athlete he was. I knew that 3 or 4 years it was going to be, he probably wouldn't be hanging around much. So I had a pretty good idea. I didn't know CP at all, but I kind of had a feeling if anytime they're a first round draft pick or late first round, early second round, those kids usually go.
From the point of time y'all came in to now, you really haven't seen any live action. Obviously, the guys that are still here, they don't really have much film to go on either. How do you evaluate the current players to figure out who you want to get in this recruiting class?
Well, you know what? I wish we could handle it that way. Right now, it's who's interested. Who can we build a relationship with quick? Who did they have a previous relationship with, the coaches that were here before us? Who do we have that we were recruiting in other places? Who do we have a shot at? Next year, we could probably be a little more picky, but right now, we got to go find guys that are interested that we can build a relationship fast and convince them that this is the place for them. So,
when you guys came in, did you find that the previous staff had like anticipated this was a big year for receivers and had laid groundwork in that direction or not?
You know what? I don't know. I can't crawl in their heads and know what they were thinking. You know, Coach Graham's done an unbelievable job, and the people that are still left here in our recruiting office of trying to hold it together and keep us on some of the same kids that they were on. But I don't know what their plan was. If they planned on losing those guys, I don't know.
What have you said? You talked to each of these guys. What have you told them about the opportunities? Obviously, there's been a whole lot of experience there, and that here's opportunity for everybody. What's the message you gave?
Well, I told them that everyone has an opinion. You know, I've heard from all the people that are still here, I've heard, hey, his strengths is this, his weakness is this, you know. He's limited in this, but he's good in this. And I told him that's all good, but I'll form my own opinion. Our morning workouts will be huge, our 6 a.m. We call them the standard. Our standards will be huge in the mornings just to kind of see where we're at, you know, athletically, what I do have. So, you know, some of these kids I recruited, you know, Vincent Dallas, we had on a visit when I was at that other place. And so I kind of understand what he can do. The other guys, we'll see. So we'll go from there. They all have a clean slate. They all have an opportunity day one. I don't care. Walk on, scholarship, third year, fourth, it doesn't matter. We're gonna put the best guys out there.
What made this job appealing to you coming in from Wisconsin?
If you walk around here, I mean, this place is, there's none like this in the country. I mean, this place is special. I mean, for me to have an opportunity to coach at a place that's nicknamed after my position, I mean, I'm a receiver guy by heart. I've had other opportunities to coach other positions. I'm a wideout coach, that's my passion. So to come here at a place where receivers should be, I mean, they should be knocking at our door, quite honestly. And we need to get that back. We need to get that back where it's a little bit easier to recruit a wideout here. So they understand the tradition of playing here. Playing that position here is a big deal. So it was very, very, very appealing. Plus, the staff is really what drove me here. Next to the brand name of Tennessee was, I've coached with Coach Jones, I've coached with Coach Jake, I've coached with all of these guys minus Coach Graham. And from what I've gotten to know of him, Coach Jones did a good job because he fits us perfectly. So it's a seamless transition offensively for me too. I helped Coach Jake and the rest of these guys build this offense in Central Michigan before I went to that place down south there. So I'm excited. I'm real excited.
When you think of Tennessee receivers and the bad reputation wide receiver, you comes to mind. Who do you remember?
Well, I mean, the old guys especially. You know, the Alvin Harpers of the world, the Carl Pickens of the world, Joey Kent. You know, those guys. I got to meet. I was like a little kid. I got to meet Joey Kent the other day, and I'm like, please come back. Come back. Sit in the receiver meetings. You know, help me with these guys. They need to know what they're sitting in. And I'm not sure they know that yet. They need to know who's played here before them. And it's real easy. If we're not as good as those guys, the program gets worse. Their position gets worse. And so I want them to feel a little uneasy, like, oh my God, really? Joey Kent had this many catches? Yeah, he did. That's why we got to go play and practice really hard. So, you know, you're the next Joey Kent.
Was that here that Joey Kent was here?
Mm-hmm. So,
yeah. What are the key attributes you look for in a receiver?
You know, besides from the talent issues, obviously we want speed. Who doesn't want speed, right? That's a given. I want guys that can create separation. And I'm going to tell you, after 15 years of doing this, I want personality. I want guys that have different personalities and bring a little bit different edge to the field. I don't need a 6'5 guy. I don't need a 5'8 guy. I need a mix of both. Guys that have loose hips, guys that attack the ball, and guys that can play in a no-huddle, up-tempo offense, you know, from an endurance standpoint, and have the mentality to do that. So personality is big these days. You know, if you bring in the right or wrong one, it could change your program.
Zach, when you were coaching in the Rose Bowl, I mean, how quickly did you get here? Were you here the next day? And how's the adjustment been?
I don't even know
here?
What day is it. Well, let's see. We got done at the Rose Bowl. That was a heartbreaker. The next day, got on a plane, flew home. I got three little girls. Got home about midnight. It was about 6 degrees. Car didn't start in the parking garage. So it was a rough night. And got on the first plane the next morning on the 3rd and came here and was here. And then hit the road recruiting.
I guess you've been here a week then. Just you touched on being familiar with these guys. I mean, how's the adjustment been? Has there been much of one?
We've had a couple team meetings, a couple opportunities to sit down with all the wideouts. They're still coming in individually, but it's been great. They're juiced up, man. They love the vibe. They love the energy that's going on right now. Because I ask them all, what's your feel right now with the place? What do you guys think? And we're like, Coach, everyone's got a little bit different bounce in their step right now. Everyone's real excited. The attitude is different. There's just a renewed life, which there should be with a change. So they're excited.
What about out on the road? What's your reception been out on the road, Zach?
It really depends where you go. I mean, you walk in with a T on your shirt. That's a brand name. It's really hard to know right now. Obviously, in Tennessee, it's great. We need to get some of it back, and we are. But right now, we're really just trying to get in on a kid and build a quick relationship with moms and dads and high school coaches. So I haven't had an opportunity to really gauge what everyone is feeling is.
And then, as recruiting coordinator, what do you feel like are your strengths that enable you to hold that position? And what are the keys to that position?
Well, one of the keys is I know what Coach Jones likes. That's why I'm the recruiting coordinator. You know, we have a lot of similar tastes. Pet peeves and things like that, and what we think kids these days like. We all understand that it could be anything that makes or breaks a kid's decision. It could be the way that a professor talks to him, could be the lights weren't on in the indoor. It could be anything like that might make or break a kid in recruiting. And I think that I understand what Coach Jones wants and what this staff wants, so I'm going to do my best. We got a heck of a recruiting department that are on board and they're rolling. Our support up there is fantastic. So my strength is just getting organized, understand what our staff wants, what Coach Jones wants. He doesn't have to tell me what he wants. And I think that's probably one of the reasons he made me the recruiting coordinator.
You guys are all really active on social media. Is that more for a recruiting tool?
Yeah, you know, and I'm pressing the guys as we go here. You know, some of them are a little uncomfortable with it. I'm pressing it as we go. Hey, you need to learn this. You need to, I got Jimmy's helping me with, no, you got to do it. I mean, that's just part of the deal these days. That's how kids respond. That's how kids, some of them are just a little intimidated by it. Maybe some of our older coaches, but they're doing a great job really jumping on board. So yeah, that's a tool for sure.
How did your time at school down south help you for being in the SEC and the expectations?
I was just telling Coach Thigpen the other day, I learned more in 1 year at that place than I have my whole career as far as just the scope and magnitude of recruiting at this level. Playing on the big stage, we're all football coaches, it really doesn't matter, stadiums and all that, but recruiting is huge. Recruiting at this level is different, it really, really is. It prepared me for Wisconsin and it prepared me for this, and so I really feel like that was huge. We signed the number one class in the country at one point there, and how we did that and the dynamics it took to do that really, really gave me an idea of what we have to do in order to do that here.
What is different about recruiting in the SEC versus even other BCS schools?
Right, it's a street fight every day. I mean, you take a day off, you're going to get beat. So it's ultra competitive every single day, every single hour. Again, not knowing exactly what my tourniquet. We all have great facilities. We all have good people. We all have big stadiums. We all have nice carpet in the locker rooms. Finding what's going to just give you that little edge and separate you just a little bit to make that kid make a decision. You're trying to search for that every single day at a place like Tennessee.
Can you talk about your recruiting background a little bit, maybe geographically, kind of what areas you've worked and what you feel comfortable with?
Well, I'm really a South Florida guy is where I really, really kind of cut my teeth. I spent a lot of time down in Miami, Broward, Dade County, but I've recruited all over Florida, Ohio. I've recruited a lot of Ohio, a lot of Michigan, Kentucky, a lot of those places, Wisconsin. I've recruited a ton everywhere.
So. Are you going to work Florida?
I don't know. We haven't split it up yet. Right now, it's kind of by position. How we recruit right now, and then once the dust settles a little bit, we'll go back through and see where everyone's best at.
Is it going to be your call on who goes where, what region?
It'll be coach's call. Yeah, he'll want to do that, and just kind of the staff. We're gonna who has relationships, who has prior relationships. That's
got
huge.
Terry Farron, you know, also.
So.
Mm-hmm. And are there any Tennessee traditions you're looking forward to the most while you're here?
The fall walk. Looking forward to that. You know, I'm a college football fan too. I love the pageantry of it all. That's why I really don't have any aspirations going to the next level. I love college. So the fall walk, just game day here. I played in this stadium on the bad sideline. I'm on the good sideline now. So just playing in that stadium again and all the traditions that come with it. Yeah.